Okay. All right. So I have a solution of copper and zinc sulfate, which took me quite a while to actually get to this concentration. The objective for today is going to see if I can't precipitate out the copper along with the zinc, and hopefully just reduce the copper oxide back to copper metal and remove the zinc impurities. I wanted to do this originally with iron, because iron is higher on the reactivity series than copper and below zinc, but I'm going to use aluminum foil instead because I don't have any pure sources of zinc. The aluminum foil is higher on the series than zinc as well, so we're going to precipitate both metals. I'm going to add it to a test tube and hopefully see it working. I'm just going to add an arbitrary amount. That might be too much. There's not going to be very much copper, because this is from like 5 or 6 pennies, so we're looking at maybe 5 grams tops. Okay, that'll be aluminum foil in small portions. Can I see the test tube from here? Yes, now I can. We're adding the aluminum foil. I don't know how long it'll take to react, but it doesn't look that vigorous. I'm gonna keep the solution for now. Addition of the aluminum foil, nothing really is happening. There might be a passivating layer, some oxide, preventing it from reacting. I was hoping for something. Let me try scratching some of the foil to remove the oxide. See if that works. I'm just taking a nail and scratching. Both sides. There. Let's try it. That's interesting. The foil that I scratched sunk right to the bottom, but the one that I didn't is floating on top, so there's a density difference. It could be I squished this one a little bit and there's an air pocket in there, maybe, but I don't think so. Well, that's unfortunate. I'm gonna see what I can do with this.